Hi everyone, my name is Reggie. Welcome to this video about the new geyser system from Mafra. We created this system because there is a lot of steamers out there that have been adapted to the car wash or have been adapted to interiors, but there is no complete system. This is the reason why we went to the producer with all the feedback we had from all the detailers in the world to make sure that we can create 100% a total complete system for the interior and exterior of the car. For the construction of this brilliant apparatus, we took the liberty of creating a machine that has light, durable materials so we can work long and make sure the machine performs at its best for long periods of time. A special feature of this machine is that we created a boiler system that's not conventional, as you know, with copper, but with inox inducted material, so there's no lime scaling. Also, because of the stainless steel material, it can hold its bars, like 160 bars, more easily than in the same use as we use copper, because copper needs more density to create enough pressure to withhold the 160 bars. We have a selection of multiple nozzles to clean every part of the car inside and out. There is no external water system needed because we can provide the car with a wet steam and a dry steam. And this is to be because of the creation of the Enox boiler. Wet steam, dry steam. What are the differences and how do we create it? We have in our boiler system, an extra additive that will give us, from the boiler, heated water to create wet steam. Other systems use external water just to provide extra water to the steam system itself, but it's not heated or poorly heated. So what we did is, from the boiler itself, create an extra jet of water to make the steam more wet so you can get a more rinsing effect, or if you want to keep it dry, just to loosen up the dirt from the surface. And how it looks like, I will show you. First, dry steam. Steam power full nozzle to the left. Sorry, the twist to the left. Steam water jet closed. We have saved 7 bars ready to use. Second, wet steam. Open valve to the max. And let's see how wet steam looks like. Well, it's actually great to see that this part is already almost completely dry. Sweet. Benefits of dry steam: cleaning and not a lot of drying time. Wet steam. I think we have our difference right there. One of the great features we also thought about was the size of the machine. So it's very important to have a slender size to meet the measurements so we can work inside buses, trains, airplanes, or mobile homes or whatsoever. Like I said, it's a 4-in-1 total system. So we have a separate vacuum system, we have a separate foaming system, we have a separate dry steam system regulated, and a wet steam system regulated, so we can increase and decrease the amount of pressure we need with steam or with wet steam. We have a stabilized output of 6 bars. That means we can work with 6 bars constantly. It will not fluctuate too much because sometimes we need more steam and we need less steam. But the most important thing is that we want to create a system so you can keep working. One of the great features is that the maintenance of this machine is very low. We only have to clean the boiler once a week. And because of the inox induction in the inside, there's no lime scaling residue that's going to stay onto the surface, but will decrease the performance in the machine in a long period of time. It's easy to clean, so you can keep working with the machine.
The operation of the machine is also very simple. We have our main power to switch on the machine for the electricity. We have our boiler system to create the boiler. We already see we have it on a ready temperature. Here we can see on the right side, we have the amount of pressure that's now available for the performance of the product itself. We have the regulation of steam, high power steam versus low power steam, and of course the amount of water we want to create with our steam. Analog use, so we can meet all demands necessary for every type of cleaning we need to do with this machine. So we're going to treat a small piece of upholstery from a car to show you the versatility of this product and what it can do. We're going to do it step by step. I'm going to start with the normal vacuuming of the part we're going to clean. Single use for the vacuum. We have many nozzles, extensions we can use. We'll switch on main power and then go for a manual vacuum power. The great thing is this machine has a 1.1 kilowatt engine, but because the engine is smaller and upgraded, it's like a high performance supercharged vacuum engine, it has an output of a 1.6 kilowatt power. Now if you walk here on the back side of the machine, we can see we have here have our water supply and we have our additive supply. In this case we use the dilution of 1 to 10 with the APC of APCs from Labo Cosmetica called Ductile. We have here the air, and on the front side we're going to connect the foaming agent system. We have the air, we can regulate ourselves and say if like maybe try a 3 bars of pressure to create some foam. For the use of the foam, we only need to switch on the foam pump. We have some nice foam coming out of there. It's real dense. You can see it's a beautiful, dense, light foam. So we have a lot of time. And Ductile, of course, is a low foaming product, but because of the use in this case of extra air, we can create a foam. But this foam will not build up in the machine. It will actually return to its normal state. So it will just become water with a little bit of detergent, in this case, Ductile. Let's go for the steam. Go to make sure the main power is switched on. I go for the boiler. It has an internal fan, so it keeps the machine cool, but it will keep the machine from performing at its best. So it's like the inside of a computer, always has a fan. And this has an internal fan to keep that cooling action going on. We're going to wait until the pressure gauge is at its working pressure at 7 bars. The inside of this machine, there's a 3 kilowatt boiler, and this 3 kilowatt boiler performs like a 380 volt powered machine, but it's actually just 220. So it's very versatile in every way and everyday use. Also keeps down the costs of the use of the machine itself. While we wait before the machine is at pressure, oh, it's already at pressure, so that's fantastic to see that it goes very fast. We have the connector right here to make sure the lock is on. So we have a safe use of the machine. I'm going to regulate it for the wet steam. So I'm going to put out high pressure for steam. I'm going to put high water. Very easy click on, very easy click off. And make sure that everything's checked. Double check, cross check. Now we have an internal switch to go for extraction as well. So we don't have to walk back to the machine. So that is remote controlled, as we say. I'm going to turn off the water of the steam to make it completely dry. I'm going to do two steps. I'm going to do one step with dry steam to make sure that we got everything out. I'm going to do one step with just a vacuum to make sure that all the humidity is out of the seat, so we can reapply the seat into the car and start using the car again. Turn down the wetness, going up in the steam, staying the same. You can see still we have a nice pressure, a constant output of 6 bars, which is very important because we do not want any fluctuation. You can already see the difference in moisture. This part is still very wet. This part is becoming very damp. It's just because of the sacrificial steam that's still on the surface. And now for the last, just the vacuum, and that's it. The wetness test. Dry. We have here the depressurizer of the self-cleaning system. Once a week, we maintain to drop down to 2 bars of pressure in the boiler and then just drain the boiler using the valve. You can see even after blowing off all that steam, we still don't have a large buildup of foam. What very important is, because we do not want to clog up the machine. Now you can see it's very easy to remove the filter. It's just one twist lock system. For the rest, yes, the drainage system of this. Many different attachments we can use. For the manual vacuum, your standard attachment, the brush attachment, of course. For the steam system, this nozzle. We of course have our extraction, easy on, easy off. We can switch to a spot section and make another attachment to do a steam and a brushing action and a vacuum action. So I'm making 3 things in once. Very awesome. I like this one very much. It's gonna save a lot of time. We have the foaming system and, optional of course, with a twist lock system. We can use these just if we want to clean hard to reach areas with an easy twist locks, with an easy twist lock system, and to switch on for the harder to reach areas or the wheel areas or the engine bay. So a total 4-in-1 complete system for the whole inside and outside of the car. Last but not least, let's see the drainage. For environmental purposes, of course, I'm not gonna dump it all into the... To summarize, the geyser system from Mavra, we have a 4-in-1 total complete interior and exterior system, steam system for the car. Vacuum, dry steam, wet steam, a separate foam system, high performing engine giving us the power of a 1.6 kilowatt engine, a 3 kilowatt engine, of them, sorry, a 3 kilowatt for the boiler, giving us maximum output of 8 bars with a constant output of 6 bars, a tremendous amount of utilities Fantastic boiler system, inox made it, low maintenance, versatility all over. This is one total complete system. Thank you guys for watching.